Hello students, in the last session we have discussed about Maxwell's equations, time invariant Maxwell's equations and time variant Maxwell's equations, means modified Maxwell's equations, second and fourth, and still some derivations remains we have to discuss before going into the main topic. So now I am going to discuss about the electromagnetic wave. Simply how the electromagnetic wave will present. So EM wave, electric wave, magnetic wave, both are combined. So electric field is along x direction, black in color, and magnetic field is along y direction, blue in color, and the electromagnetic wave is propagating along z direction. Okay, electric field is along x direction, magnetic field is along y direction, and the electromagnetic wave is propagating along z direction. So here E cross H is equals to electromagnetic wave. Electric field is along x direction, magnetic field is along y direction, and electromagnetic wave is along z direction, that is propagation direction. Propagation direction means electromagnetic wave is moving along z direction. And ax, ay, az are nothing but unit vectors which are always representing the direction. So E x direction, H y direction, and wave, electromagnetic wave along z direction. That is nothing but transverse nature of electromagnetic waves. Transverse nature means E and H 90 degrees apart, and EM wave is also 90 degrees to the both electric field and magnetic field. So three dimensional. So how E to H transformations will be done? See, electric field x direction, magnetic field y direction. Next, electromagnetic wave will be along in z direction. The electric field is generating the magnetic field in 90 degrees. And again the magnetic field will generate the electric field in opposite direction. Opposite direction means 90 degrees, perpendicular direction. Always electric field and magnetic fields are 90 degrees apart from each other. So this electric field will generate this magnetic field, and this magnetic field will generate this electric field. So like this, E to H transformations will be done and the electromagnetic wave will move. So to get perfect E to H transformations, we need the time variant should be a harmonic function. So why the time variant should be harmonic function? So we are getting, see, if electric field is starting here, it is generating the magnetic field, and again the magnetic field is generating the electric field, the same electric field, and the same electric field is generating the same magnetic field. It means time harmonic. Means why we need time harmonic to get perfect E to H transformations? Because it is generating the same electric fields and magnetic fields. So here harmonic function is nothing but if I do the derivation, again the same function I have to get. That's why we need a harmonic function to get perfect E to H transformations. Okay, so what is a harmonic function? Example, I can consider sinusoidal signals, sine integration cos, again cos, sorry, differentiation, sine differentiation cos, cos differentiation sine, again sine cos, cos sine, sine cos, cos sine, the same function I am repeating. That's why sine and cos functions are harmonic functions. And again exponential functions, e power x. Differentiation e power x only. E power x differentiation e power x. Like that, the same function I am getting. So we can consider either exponential functions or sinusoidal functions as harmonic functions. And here we are having two types of harmonics, guys. Time harmonic and space harmonic. Time harmonic is nothing but theta directly proportional to t if I remove the proportionality constant omega. Space harmonic, theta directly proportional to z. If I remove the proportionality constant, I will get beta. Because it is time harmonic, because it is space harmonic. Okay, so omega radians per second 2 pi by t, beta radians per meter 2 pi by lambda. Lambda is nothing but wavelength. So here omega and beta both are phase shift constants. Okay, so next I am going to discuss about EH field equations in free space. EH field equations in free space. So here we have to consider modified equation, Maxwell's modified second equation. So modified Maxwell's second equation. What is modified Maxwell's second equation? Del cross E is equals to minus dou B by dou T, and we know that B is equal to mu H, and del cross E is equal to minus mu into dou H by dou T. Consider it as equation 1. Next, consider modified Maxwell's fourth equation. What is that equation? Del cross H is equals to JC plus JD, that is sigma E plus dou D by dou T, that is sigma E plus, what is D? D is equal to epsilon E, so epsilon into dou E by dou T, del cross H. But in free space, means no conductor, I am not using any material for wave transmission. I am using only free space. If free space is there, no conductor. No conductor means there is no conductivity. That is sigma. Sigma equal to 0. If sigma equal to 0, from this equation, del cross H is equal to only epsilon into dou E by dou T. This is equation 2. Now, for this equation, for equation 2, apply del cross on both sides. So, what I will get? Del cross H is equals to del cross epsilon dou E by dou T. For del cross H, there is one formula. One vector identity will be there for del cross H. So that formula is del cross H is equals to del of del dot H minus del square H. Just apply this formula on left side of this equation. So del of del dot H minus del square H is equal to what we are having? Del cross epsilon dou E by dou T on right side. So as epsilon is constant, we can write dou by dou T here only. Del cross is applied for this electric field intensity. Okay, So for charge free region, del dot H is equal to 0. For charge free region. So what I will have, minus del square H is equal to epsilon dou by dou T into, what is del cross E? Del cross E is equals to minus mu into dou H by dou T. That is from equation 1. So here del square H is equal to mu epsilon dou square H by dou T square, like this. So similarly, I will get del square E is equal to mu epsilon dou square E by dou T square. So this del square H and del square E are space harmonics, and dou square E by dou T square, dou square H by dou T square, these are called time harmonics. Okay, because we are having dou by dou T, dou by dou T differentiation. Differentiation means with respect to time, these are varying. That's why time harmonics. If we are having del, del is nothing but it is always deals with a space. So that's why it is known as space harmonics. So these are the EH field equations in free space, and we got equation for space harmonics and time harmonics. So this is very, very important derivation. So just derive the, or they can write, they can ask you in the examinations like this. Just write down the space harmonic equations and time harmonic equations, or write down the relationship between space harmonics and time harmonics, just for 2 marks. You just need to write these two equations. That's it. Okay, next we'll see EH field equations in general materials. Okay, so we know this equation, del cross E is equals to minus mu into dou H by dou T, and del cross H is equal to sigma E plus epsilon into dou E by dou T. These are discussed in the previous derivation, 1 and 2 equation. Just consider. So here we have to represent every electromagnetic wave, every electromagnetic wave should be represented, should be represented using harmonics, harmonic source at one end. So I am considering E is equal to E naught into e power j omega t, and H is equal to H naught into e power j omega t. So we already discussed what is harmonic, harmonic source. So these are nothing but, if we do the derivations, we have to get the same. So either we can consider exponential or sinusoidal. Here I have considered exponential. Again, and we know that e power j theta or e power j omega t, if I expand this one, we'll get cos theta plus j sin theta. Again, sinusoidal only. Okay. So here del cross E is equal to, from equation 1, minus mu dou by dou T, and what is H? H naught into e power j omega t. If I do the differentiation, I will get, we have to do the differentiation with respect to T, so H naught will become constant. So e power j omega t differentiation is e power j omega t, and again the differentiation of j omega t will get j omega. So here we'll write del cross E is equals to minus j omega mu, and I will write simply h, because what is h? H is nothing but h naught into e power j omega t. Instead of this I will write h. So consider this as equation 3. Now whatever we did for del cross E, just do for del cross h. That is del cross h is equal to, we are having sigma e. E is nothing but e naught into e power j omega t plus epsilon into dou by dou t of e naught into e power j omega t. So it is simplified as epsilon naught e power j omega t, and it is j omega. So del cross h is equal to, just take out e naught into e power j omega t as common. So I will get sigma plus j omega epsilon, and e naught into e power j omega t can be written as e. So consider this as equation 4. Now from 3 take h equation, what is equation 3? Del cross E is equal to minus j omega mu h. So from here h is equal to del cross E by minus j omega mu. Consider it as equation 5. Now substitute this equation 5 in equation 4. Substitute equation 5 in 4. What you will get? Del cross H is nothing but minus del cross E by j omega mu is equal to sigma plus j omega epsilon into E. So for charge free region, del dot E is equal to 0. So what is charge free region? That is nothing but inside the conductor. So inside the conductor is always considered as charge free region. So why we have to consider it as charge free region means, there is some loss. Charge will not, if we consider a conductor, always the charge is present on the surface, not inside the conductor. So that's why the inside the conductor we can consider it as a charge free region. Okay, always charges are present on the surface, not inside the conductor. The charge distribution is just simply as surface charge distribution, which is always on the surface, not inside. So that's why we can consider inside the conductor as a charge free region. If it is a charge free region, we can consider this is del dot E is equal to 0, because we already discussed del cross E, the vector identity. From this vector identity, del cross E, from this vector identity we are having this formula minus del square E, and this is equal to 0. Now left hand side we can write, already we are having minus, and this minus will become plus. So del square E, okay, and in the denominator we are having j omega mu, and it will become as j omega mu. If I move this as a right hand side, j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon into E. So finally del square E is equal to j omega mu E into sigma plus j omega epsilon. So similarly, we'll get del square h is equal to j omega mu h sigma plus j omega epsilon. Okay, so here finally, this is very very important, and this can be written as del square E is equal to gamma square E, del square H is equal to gamma square H. Okay, so in these two cases, what is gamma square? Gamma square is nothing but j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon, or gamma is equal to under root of j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon. So this is nothing but propagation constant. Okay, so electromagnetic wave is propagating along z direction, so it is having some constant which is involved in some parameters, so it is known as propagation constant. Okay, here gamma is nothing but alpha plus j beta, because here it is having some real and imaginary term. If I multiply this into inside, I will get one real term, one imaginary term. So alpha is real, beta is imaginary. So here alpha is attenuation constant and beta is phase shift constant. So we are having both attenuation and we are having both this phase shift. Okay, so that's all for this today guys, and some more definitions and derivations are still pending to enter into actual topic. Okay, thank you.